Mumbai Port is one of the major ports of India. It is a unique port as it is a multi-purpose cargo handling port. It can handle barges, boats, vessels, cruise liners and various types of cargo from pins to project. It has 23 berths and a lock gate inside the basin to maintain a draft for easy movement of ships to and fro the docks. Steel. Mumbai Port handles large amount of steel plates, coils, skid bundles, both import and export for various companies. Agri-export. Mumbai Port is well placed to handle export of sugar and other agri products like rice, soybean meal, wheat, maize. Automobiles. Mumbai Port is biggest exporter of cars in the country. Ro-Ro vessels are handled at OCT or BPX. Mumbai Port provides lot of facilities to the auto exporters like 30 free days PDI facilities. Project Cargo. Mumbai Port effectively handles large amount of huge dimensional project cargoes with experienced supervisory staff. Bunkering Terminal. It is developed at Marine Oil Terminal, expanding the capacity to 2 million tons. Marine Oil Terminal. Mumbai Port handles crude oil for various oil companies. This has been possible because of an engineering marvel developed at Marine Oil Terminal. Various companies like BPCL, HPCL, Indian Oil use this facility. The crude oil is transferred under the sea to their refineries by underground pipelines. Upcoming cargo projects at Mumbai Port. Cement silos. Oil terminal. Third chemical berth. FSRU. Mumbai JNPT barge. Mumbai Port Trust is scaling new heights in handling cruise ships with rapidly increasing employment opportunities and economic spin-off. Last year, Mumbai Port handled 44 international and 177 domestic cruise calls. Tourism projects at Mumbai Port. Domestic cruise terminal. Ropex terminal. 1 kilometer waterfront tourism and transportation hub. Ballard Estate Festival. Floating restaurants. Upcoming tourism projects at Mumbai Port Trust. Kanoji Angre Lighthouse. A lighthouse tourism destination developed by Mumbai Port. Mumbai International Cruise Terminal. 4 lakh square feet in size. This facility shall be extensively used for cruise ships, tourists and local citizens. Marina. 300 boats can park at a time. Ropeway. Longest ropeway over the sea from Haji Bandar to Elephanta. Water taxi. From DCT to Nerul, Belapur and Navi Mumbai International Airport. Overall, Mumbai Port is developing itself and is future ready both in terms of cargo and tourism. It is being developed on the lines of London and Barcelona Port.
Thank you. rising out of the Arabian Sea, Kanhoji Angre Lighthouse stands sentinel, helping in navigation of ships at the entry point of Mumbai Harbour, located about 13 nautical miles from Mumbai. The lighthouse is built over an island steeped in a fascinating history. In the 17th century, the Maratha Empire had built a formidable naval power on the western coast along the Konkan area. Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj had fortified the Khanderi Island and secured it as a naval base. The island was handed over to Maratha naval chief Kanhoji Angre in the early 18th century. He developed it as a strategic naval base to monitor the movement of British and Portuguese ships. The island eventually came in control of the British, who made a beacon here in 1852 to guide ships to Mumbai port. In 1867, the current lighthouse was built and fitted with a unique lamp with mirrors and prisms to magnify and project the light across long distances. The island is under the control of Mumbai Port Trust, and in 1998, the island and the lighthouse were named in honor of the legendary Admiral Kanhoji Angre. Mumbai Port Trust is developing Kanhoji Angre Island as a lighthouse tourism destination, starting from the domestic cruise terminal. Catamarans with capacity of over 50 passengers will ferry the tourists to the island. The distance will be covered in about 1.5 hours. For the convenience of tourists, Mumbai Port Trust has built a direct access passenger landing jetty. Rising to a height of 25 meters, Kanhoji Angre Lighthouse is built over a beautiful structure of stones. Spread over an area of 18 acres, the island is bound by ramparts of the fort. Beyond the ramparts is the rocky beach. Mumbai Port Trust is now coming up with a host of facilities for the tourists at Kanhoji Angre Island. Lighthouse. Temple Trails. Tree Avenue and Walkways. Amphitheatres. Green Adventure. Rock Adventure. Cafeteria and Food Courts. Water sports, camping sites, light and sound shows. Mumbai Port Trust is all set to offer yet another iconic tourist destination, loaded with flavors of history and adventure on the waters of Arabian Sea in the form of Kanhoji Angre Lighthouse Tourism.
Imagine a cruise voyage from Mumbai to Goa along the fascinating Konkan coastline, taking forward its finest maritime traditions with changing times. Mumbai Port Trust has built India's first state-of-the-art domestic cruise terminal at the iconic Victoria Dock of Mumbai. A splendorous voyage between Mumbai and Goa on a modern cruise ship is now a reality. As a part of ambitious Eastern Seafront Development Plan, Mumbai Port Trust has launched a domestic cruise service between Mumbai and Goa. Next to Bhaucha Dhakka, one of the oldest ferry terminals of Mumbai, is the iconic Victoria Dock. A dilapidated structure was transformed into a dedicated state-of-the-art domestic cruise terminal by Mumbai Port Trust under Ministry of Shipping. The terminal has a direct hassle-free access for passengers and general public and has a clear evacuation plan in place. As the evening transforms to night, the seaside terminal bathes in a spectacular glow. The three-floor structure has terminal, restaurant and cafeteria facilities. On the non-cruise days, the facility can be used for public events and shows. The terminal will also have water taxi and catamaran services. A neighbouring old structure will be transformed into a spectacular marina and ropax terminal. With an ultra-modern seafront restaurant, the entire area will become a popular tourist hub. Angria, the first luxury cruise ship in the history of India, is all set to begin a fascinating voyage from the domestic cruise terminal. Domestic cruise tourism from Mumbai will unleash a new world of coastal exploration for the travellers. In the times to come, cruise services will reach places like Karnataka, Kerala and Gujarat. Heralding a new dawn, Mumbai Port Trust is geared up to lead the Indian cruise tourism to a glorious journey.
Mumbai Harbour has witnessed spectacular maritime growth over the last two centuries that played a defining role in making the city the financial capital of the nation. Mumbai Port Trust has been at the forefront of this journey, enabling international trade and commerce, making Mumbai one of the leading cargo ports of the world. Mumbai Port Trust is now on a mission to transform Mumbai Port into a world-class tourism port, unleashing its immense potential of waterfront tourism. The coastline of Mumbai is set to witness international and domestic cruise tourism, ropax services, marina, floating restaurants, marine drive jetty and seaplane, mangrove park, ropeway over the sea, lighthouse tourism. A whole new Mumbai Port Waterfront Tourism Hub is coming up near Ferry Wharf. The hub will have a spectacular iconic building, heralding the dawn of domestic cruise tourism in India. Mumbai Port Trust has built a state-of-the-art domestic cruise terminal at historical Victoria Dock area with a fine infrastructure for the tourists. Cruise service between Mumbai and Goa has begun from the domestic cruise terminal. Tourists will also be able to visit places like Kanhochi Angri Lighthouse from here. The next experience for the tourists will be an amphitheater by the sea. A world-class seaside restaurant at Ropax Terminal will add unique flavor to the waterfront tourism hub. Next on the waterfront, skating rink and a cycling track. A ropax service is being launched between Ferry Wharf in Mumbai and Mandwa near Alibag, using water transportation for fast movement of vehicles. An area of 5 hectares is being transformed into a beautiful marina with capacity to berth 300 boats and yachts. This fascinating waterfront is being developed by transforming old structures into state-of-the-art modern tourism hub, and a systematic vehicle parking and traffic evacuation plan is being put in place. Cruising or anchored small ships starting from domestic cruise terminal will offer a fine dining experience amid sea breeze overlooking the coastline of Mumbai. The 1 kilometer waterfront stretch is being transformed into the Eastern Water Transport Hub for water taxis, domestic cruises, ropax, catamarans and floating restaurants. One of the most important landing points of fishing boats in Mumbai is Sassoon Dock. To preserve this iconic fishing dock area, Mumbai Port Trust is set to transform it into a modern fishing boat hub. A state-of-the-art international cruise terminal is coming up at Mumbai Port, which will witness a major increase in arrival of international cruise ships and tourists. Mumbai Port Trust is offering a host of facilities to cruise operators and passengers. World's longest ropeway on the eastern seafront will give a new tourism identity to the city of Mumbai. Overlooking the habitat of the flamingos, it will take the tourists to the World Heritage Site of Elephanta Caves Island. Instilling spirit of nature conservation among the visitors, a spectacular mangrove park is coming up on 10 acres of land in Siri. The park will have fascinating trails made up of bamboo, watchtowers and seating areas. A botanical garden called Sagar Upwan will be another green experience on the Mumbai seafront. With an aim for protection of environment, Mumbai Port Trust is installing a large capacity sewage treatment plant. The treated water will be reused commercially in various industries. 150 years old, magnificent lighthouse is dedicated to the legendary Maratha naval chief Kanhoji Angre. A short cruise from domestic cruise terminal port will bring tourists to explore the nature trails and heritage walks on the island. A world-class experience awaits the Indian and international tourists as Mumbai Port Trust unfolds a fascinating array of adventure, nature conservation and modern tourism in the form of Mumbai Port Waterfront Tourism Hub.
I am Mumbai Harbour. Calmness is my strength. Thus, I am able to handle all rough. Hence, Mumbai Port was built at my coast. Who would have imagined the seven islands with fishing folks by the great Arabian Sea would be the financial capital of the country? Well, this was possible only and only because of Mumbai Port Trust. Let us dwell into the time. On my waters, Maratha, British and Portuguese navies played hide-and-seek war games to control the Bombay Islands. In 1652, East India Company urged Queen for my purchase from Portuguese, which was realized a few years later as a dowry perhaps in the marriage treaty between the Prince Charles II of Britain and Catherine of Portuguese. As an harbour, I am witness to the progress of various landmarks within Mumbai Port, which have stood the tides of time. Let me take you through each of them. The first of the present-day weight docks, Sassoon Dock, was built in 1870, now used as a fishing dock. First board meeting of the Mumbai Port Trust was held on 3rd July 1873 in Darbar Hall of the Asiatic Library Building. Apollo Bandar, the site of present-day Gateway of India, was opened for passenger traffic in 1819. To commemorate arrival of King and Queen, a replica of Gateway of India was built here in 1911. Bhau Chadhakka, built by Bhau Lakshman Harichandraji Ajinkya in 1841 for the convenience of passengers as well as for ships to berth, load and embark. This included Karnak and Clare Bandars. I am witness to the construction of first lighthouse in 1850 on an island renamed in 1998 as the Kanhoji Angre Dweep after the great Maratha naval chief Kanhoji Angre. Let me give you a brief of various docks built by Mumbai Port to handle cargo. The Princess Dock was built in 1880 as a part of the scheme for improving my entire foreshore. The Victoria Dock was inaugurated in the year 1888. The Princess and Victoria Dock Traffic Office, the Ghadiyal Godi Building, was the first building at the port. The foundation stone of Alexandra Dock was laid on 13th November 1905. With its large shades, the cargo activity was bustling. Various gates to the docks were identified with different colors. Alexandra Dock was renamed as Indira Dock in 1972. Hugest Dry Dock. It is one of the largest dry dock in Asia. Currently, it is operated by Cochin Shipyard Limited. Let me give you the brief into various structures, buildings built to facilitate the cargo work in the docks. The Port House, headquarters of Mumbai Port, was built in 1891. Next to it, New Custom House, built in 1924. Mumbai Port reclaimed 22 acres of land at Ballard Estate between 1914 and 1918 using material excavated from the Alexandra Dock. This was a planned development executed between 1908 and 1914. During 1915, Mumbai Port developed its own railway system and constructed Ballard Pier Mole Station. Two very important trains started from Ballard Pier during early days, Golden Temple Mail and the Punjab Mail. Both the trains travelled to Peshawar in Pakistan prior to partition. Legendary personalities Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar and Mahatma Gandhi travelled overseas by boarding ship at the passenger terminal. Bharat Ratna Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar visited Mumbai Port in 1948. Erected at Ballard Estate, this war memorial commemorates the contribution made by the port in the British war effort. With railway network till the Vidarbha, cotton export from Mumbai Port saw a huge growth. To manage this trade better, the cotton exchange was opened in 1924. The explosion occurred on 14th April 1944 in the Victoria Docks of Mumbai, when the freighter SS Fort Stickin, carrying a mixed cargo of cotton bales, gold and ammunition, including around 1,400 tons of explosives, caught fire and was destroyed in two giant blasts. The blasts cut the ship in two parts, shattering windows over 12 kilometers of its radius. Post-independence, the Marine Oil Terminal was constructed by Mumbai Port Trust at Butcher Island, now known as Jawahar Dweep. It has five oil jetties to handle crude oil tankers. With this great legacy, I am also a witness to the new, modern, state-of-art tourism and transportation hub at Princess Dock, where a kilometer-long stretch along the bay is already developed and open to the citizen of Mumbai. It has a domestic cruise terminal which is already operational and has a restaurant and a beautiful landscape for events. Amphitheater by the sea with a sitting arrangement of 300 persons. For children, a skating rink. Ropex terminal to ferry person and vehicles from Mumbai to Mandwa. As a part of Eastern Waterfront Development Plan, Mumbai Port is developing itself in the line of other famous city ports like London and Barcelona. A new passenger terminal. Mumbai International Cruise Terminal is being constructed at the cost of Rs. 500 crore. I am proud of Mumbai Port, which has moved on since 18th century with these developments, in hope that in centuries ahead it will grow in usefulness for the citizens of Mumbai and in commercial splendors.